In today's illustration tutorial, you'll learn how to create custom texture brushes, how to add photo textures, and how to make all the way from the pencil sketch to finished illustration. You'll understand what's better to do in Illustrator, how to export file to Photoshop, and how to turn usual flat design into deep and detailed illustration. You're watching TNT tutorials, let's move on! These are the three stages of sketching, which usually precede a clean sketch. First, you have to choose the appropriate composition. We have an idea and we are looking for the best way to show it. We have to imagine what the drawing will look like if we move very far away from it. Everything has to be understandable even from a distance. Then we try to translate our ideas into a cleaner picture. In this case, I made two drawings, combined them, and drew the final one, which you can download on my Patreon along with the additional files for this tutorial. Let's open Illustrator, place sketch, apply multiply blending mode, decrease opacity, and lock sketch layer. Create a new layer, bring it down, and start to trace sketch in this layer. There's two things I can say about tracing today. First of all, trace everything with grayscales. You'll simply waste your time if you'll try to apply colors along with tracing. Concentrate on each shape one by one and slightly change gray. Second, relax and take your time. This process simply needs to be done and there's no other way. Turn on podcast or music, pick the pen tool and trace. Notice that I trace only main shapes and I don't care about details. That's because we'll add details and photo textures in Photoshop. Illustrator is great to create a base of illustration, and Photoshop is great to render it. I explained how to create your own color palettes, how to pick colors, and how to color grayscale tracing in this tutorial, so check it out because I used the same methods to create this color palette. My previous illustration was done in warm tones, and today's colors are in cool tones. Always think which color tones will fit your idea and don't hesitate to try warm tones for winter. It's time to export illustration to Photoshop and add details. Take a look at my layers and notice that I placed each object into separate layer. You can skip renaming if you want, but you should manage layers if you want to have them all in Photoshop. Let's click on File, Export, Export As, in File Type select PSD, and copy settings from this setup. File will be exported and we can already launch Photoshop. Let's open exported file in Photoshop. We have the same layers here as I told you, and it's time to create a custom texture brush, stipple brush, add noise, photo textures, and use blur effect to add depth. To create a custom texture brush for drawing lines, details, or simply adding texture, we'll create a new document with 500 pixels in both windows, create a new layer, and draw something like this. You can use eraser and change opacity for it to make this shape look more interesting. Then go to Edit, Define Brush Preset. Rename this brush as you want and click OK. Now, as we have this brush in the Brushes panel, we want to make it special and add texture to it. Open any texture that you want, it's better to have a large photo in good quality. Now we need to make this texture seamless, because without it we'll see rough seams in our brush while drawing. Click on Filter, Other, Offset. Move these sliders to see seams. Click OK and use the stamp tool to remove them. You don't need ideal result, any editing will work fine. Let's apply offset again and check if we have more seams left. After this, click on Edit, select Define Pattern, rename it, and we are done with it. Let's return to Illustration, select a new custom brush, open Brush Settings, check Texture, click here and select a new texture. It will always be here from now, by the way, so you can always try it with any other brush. Change mode to multiply and play with these settings to adjust texture. Also, let me show you all other settings. You can copy them for now and then play with them on your own. Now it's time to save your brush. Open this little menu and select New Brush Preset. I recommend you to check this option only and click OK. Now we can use this brush in two different ways. We can add details like this, or add textures by decreasing flow on the top panel. Make all the same steps to create a stipple brush, but this time we don't need texture. To create dots, pick standard hard round brush. Here's my settings for stipple brush. Feel free to copy them. To use this brush, select needed object first, create a new layer, hold Alt or Option key, and click between these two layers to create a clipping mask. After this, pick different color and draw like this. To add noise, duplicate needed shape and go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise, and play with this amount. Let's add photo texture. You can download photo textures anywhere in the internet. Select needed object first, open texture, and drag it here. Rotate it, change proportions if needed. Create a clipping mask as I just showed you, and try different blending modes to pick the best for your texture. After this, I usually decrease opacity and fill to make texture less visible. There's many things you can do with textures, so check this tutorial for more photo texture hints. To make these houses look a bit out of focus, let's select this area with the lasso tool and press Ctrl or Command plus C, Ctrl or Command plus Shift plus V. Go to Filter, Blur, Lens Blur, and play with these settings. To add motion to snow, we'll select needed snowflakes, click on Filter again, Blur, and select Motion Blur. Now let's make everything clear and take a look at all stages. Draw a sketch, trace it, add color, export, add details, effects, textures, and you'll have final render. I'll show a few close-ups for those who want to learn something from my approach and work in this style also. Don't forget to press thumbs up if you learned something new from this tutorial, and also subscribe so you don't miss more useful tutorials like this. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video!